District Football League match day, thanks to Buckley's Entertainment Centre.
Second semi-final, Bell Post Hill, Werribee Central's GDFL. Sean Stewart gets the first tap down of the second semi. Pushed out quickly towards Hurst and also Roland Beck coming through. Miller left the ball behind. Musara's got it. Got a high tackle. Should get a free kick and will. There's no advantage there. Howlett tried to handball it on to Carrington. Has to come back though. And Robbie Musara will take the free kick. Just inside the centre square on centre wing. Wants to go short. Does so to Roland Beck, who kept running. He's at half forward now. They're going with the wind in this first term. Wobbly floater. And it's marked easily. And they will be able to turn it around. That's Troy Feldman for Bell Post Hill. Switches play to this grandstand side. But Hurst just fell over at the crucial stage. And Chris Delaney took the mark. Play on now, the call. He has to get around Hurst. He does so. Gets back onto the right boot. Might go for goal. He does. It's in the goal square. And the arms go up. And the mark has been taken by Luke Luddick. Turns around. Umpire had called time on, so he has to come back after he's kicked it into the school.
Actually, hadn't. The umpire had put the hand up, hadn't blown the whistle, and Luke played us. It was a line ball.
Line ball. Well, it's going to come back to Luke Luddick, who's going to be kicking from the goal square when the ball comes back. And there it is, out of the tree, at the northern end. And the first opportunity for a goal, Werribee Central's, through Luke Luddick. The left footer. Well,
gee.
He's given him 50, has he, for two standing on the mark?
Yeah.
Oh, just kick the goal, Luke, please. He walks in now and kicks it for the first goal of the game. Victory Trophy's first quarter scoreboard. Werribee Central's one straight goal, 6 points. They lead Bell Post Hill, yet to score. We've been playing just on 2 minutes on the time clock, and a good start. One of the umpires in long sleeves. Oh, Mick Zeljevic. Good on you, Mick. Well done.
Yes, that's not the start we want, of course. We want to put a bit of more pressure on Werribee than that. That went down fairly easy, didn't it?
Well, it's probably a free kick caused it in the centre, Laurie. Perhaps that's early match nerves. You get them occasionally. In the centre of the ground now, we've got one goal to Werribee Central's. Bell Post Hill get the score. We've been playing 2 minutes. Up goes the ball. Stewart in there with Michelson. Stewart clearly gets a tap backwards for Stuka. Runs onto the ball. Can't pick it up though. He's under a bit of pressure, but he puts it the foot to the ball. And now he puts the foot to the accelerator. Runs away from Lurie on that occasion, which is a surprise. Lurie a foot runner. But for Stuka, really put the big ones in the first 10 metres there. Kick the ball along the ground further, and it's over the boundary line. Between centre wing and half forward flank in front of the social club here at the St Albans ground. Boundary umpire with the ball. Stewart now a kick behind the game. Howlett doing the ruck work with Miller. There's a whistle on play. It's gone to the man in front in Andrew Howlett. And the ruck infringement there. Howlett of Werribee Central's has the free kick. Drives it straight into the corridor. That's the place for it to be. Up high for the mark. Not taken. Comes to Massara at ground level.
No.
Just a little. Well, what's happened here? I think if that's a goal, it should be allowed to play. The advantage, surely.
Yeah, you're right, Eric.
And who was that kicked the ball?
Warren Foley, I think, kicked it.
Foley of the Werribee Central side, so advantage paid. Excellent goal, excellent build-up there from the Werribee side. The Victory Trophy scoreboard now 3 minutes into the first quarter. Two goals Werribee Central's, Bell Post still yet to score.
It's interesting, Jase, that you see the way that the Central's boys have set up their forward line with the likes of Lee, Buck and Howlett in there. They've left Howlett, or Howlett's left himself at centre-half forward and put Buck and Lee down at right across the forward line. Lee stays put and Buck leads up the ground, so it leads a fair hole there.
And Luddick basically at Howlett's feet.
Just roving off Luke Luddick, yeah.
Back in the middle, umpire Andrew throws the ball up. Stewart, Michelson gets a hand to it this time. Hurst also got there. Stewart runs through without the footy. Delaney's there as well. And still in the middle, pack develops. Umpire Andrew lets it go. Handball out. Came out towards Hawks, who ran off the halfback flank. Handball intercepted by Hancock. Left foot kick is okay. Oh, Walker paid the mark. And it's got it just inside the centre square. Illick gives him a lead. He goes in that direction. It's a poor kick. Feldman getting across there. Also Bernardo. He takes the mark. Adrian Bernardo at half-back out of side. Now, he goes to the left boot. Towards centre wing. Howlett gives him a lead. He goes in that direction. Oh, good mark, Andrew Howlett. And plays on quickly. Handball to Luddick. Right next to his feet, as the guy said. Goes with his left boot.
Oh, good pass.
Great pass. To the uncle, Heath Buck. Looking for 50. Got it. Has he?
No.
Oh, lucky.
That's a danger sign for us, Eric. Howlett hit the ball fairly hard, then grabbed it.
Yes, and did it very, very nicely.
Yep.
Buck goes short, and running down from half-back is Roland Beck, as he is known to do.
It's a few signs of nerves, Laurie. Bell Post still sort of not marking, not manning up, and just sort of struggling to get with their players temporarily.
Yes, I think, Eric, there's those little nerves of the remembrance of a fortnight ago, I think.
Ball still in the 50-metre zone for Werribee Centrals. Bell post till trying to break away. Simon Connolly had, but the umpire blown the whistle, and it will be a ball up.
Actually, when they got the breeze like that, I can't see why Werribee was just chipping it around. Like, they were just trying to chip it over the top into a space instead of kicking long and using what breeze they've got.
Ball up now. Lee gets it down into the pack. Hurst is there. Oh, he dives on it. Gets a kick, does he? Yes, he does. Kicking in danger. Bevan Hurst should get up and take the free kick. And he will do so now. He's in the back pocket. He switches play towards Troy Feldman. That's all right, he takes the mark uncontested. Now it has to be a pretty good kick to Lurie for Stuka, comes from behind. Good defensive play by the Whitley medalist and does well second effort. Gets his kick away, but only as far as Troy Feldman again. He wants to switch play. Where's he going to go to? He's going to go towards Scotty McDonald at centre half back, and he takes the mark. Hawks has got the job on him this afternoon. Scotty McDonald wants to move things on quickly. He was going to go by hand. Now he goes for the kick. Oh, Foley. It's okay. It's over the top of Foley's head to Connolly. Gives it outboard to Feldman. That's Troy. Goes towards Hancock and coming at it as well. Scott, good punch away. Hurst, oh, left it behind. Bennett's there. Got Scott in support. Gives it back to him. Goes a left boot. Only as far as Troy Feldman, though, probably. And he takes the mark. Troy Feldman on centre wing. Goes now with the right boot towards Hancock and also coming across. Good mark. Oh, Michelson didn't take the mark. Play on the call. Delaney breaks away. Goes with the left boot down the... That's against Sean Stewart, and it's too high. Ryan Carr will take it. Sean Stewart can't believe it. Bevan Hurst will come back and take the kick, in fact. And he's got it on centre wing. Grandstand side. Looks for something up forward. There's not much on offer. There's not too many leads. It gives him a long lead up the park. He's still holding on to it.
Be flat out kicking that far.
Well, I'll tell you, he will. Hurst, in fact, he kicks into the man on the mark. Nearly Delaney. Michelson's is there. That's Brett. He goes to the right boot, just tries to set it up for Carr. Can he get there? Yes, he can. Good pace. Made up some ground and took the grab in the right forward pocket for Bell Post Hill. Important now that they settle down here, Bell Post Hill. They've got it in their attacking zone. And he's going to go back.
The percentages are not there to pass that ball off now. He has to have a shot for that.
And we
saw an eye kick in the reserves.
Not an easy kick either.
No, but if he floats up there, that guy just standing near the back of the goal post there, it'll drift in.
Well, this is Ryan Carr, one of two.
Still
he's had a shot at
chance.
The goal, and I tell you what, it was. If it's touched, it's right on the line. What's the goal umpire going to tell us? These keys are given the goal. So the first goal of the day to Ryan Carr of Bell Post Hill. And on the Victory Trophy scoreboard now, 8 minutes into the first quarter, Werribee Central's two goals, Bell Post Hill one goal.
Well, you called it, Laurie. Go back and have a kick, didn't he?
Well, I don't believe the percentages. You can't slot the ball near to a pass, I don't think.
Could be a quick turnover if you do that, really, can't you?
For us, that's an important goal. Not only for that, there was a little bit... Stewart was free-kicked. A little bit of frustration from there. We want him frustrated. We want him to get his mind off the game and onto the something else.
He was persecuted.
Well,
it wasn't even a free-kick.
Umpire with the ball in the centre of the ground. Up it goes. Stewart again. Clearly gets the tap forward for the Werribee Central side. Intercepted by Bell Post Hill. Comes to half-forward. Hancock kicks it off the ground. But in good position there is Morley.
Oh,
Hancock, great. Stole it off the boot. Drives it to the full forward position. It's over the head of Hallam and Illick. Oh, backing up there, Bernardo. Good work for Werribee. Well, hasn't got a right foot. He's tried to kick the banana on the left foot. He's kicked a straight over in the boundary road. I think he got the wrong end of the ball, Laurie, that time. And out of bounds on the full. The subsequent free kick just outside 50. Bell Post Hill with the ball. Looks like Michelson's a tall fella. He's, well, it's a good-looking kick, but the lead was from Illick, but, well, it wasn't a good kick at the end of the day. Far too short.
They just have to be careful that he doesn't get too far sucked up the ground, Laurie, don't they?
Yeah.
I was worried about that 10 minutes ago.
Yeah.
I think we've decided we're going to put as much pressure on Werribee when they run forward as we possibly can, because they've got the breeze.
Ball out of bounds, 40 metres behind post. Stewart in front. Well, if there was a free kick, it should have been there. Stewart pushed clearly in the back, running onto the ball. Bernardo caught on the wrong foot again, and... The ball's just pushed over the boundary line and out of bounds. If I were Werribee Central, I think I'd be swapping Bernardo to this side, Pete. He's running to the boundary on his
right foot,
which is his wrong foot.
Yeah.
Umpire with the ball. 20 metres from the behind post. In it comes. Stewart, oh, up high, gets a tap to the boundary. Good work there by Massara. Turns on the right foot, heads for the safety of the boundary and just finds it because the only player there was, who was that, Messina? With Massara and Messina, they're hard to get out all at once. Yeah. But Bell Post still in the van there, but ball over the boundary line. In it comes again, just outside 50. Stewart taps it to the back. Good work from the Werribee side. Beckett is, gets the right foot into the centre. Well, Howlett put down way off the ball. No free kicks of the umpire. Mark taken by Feldman and runs away now. Drives the ball to the half forward position.
Oh, all up.
Comes, yeah, good call, Laurie. All the Bell Post Hill boys up. Scott gets the ball, clears it to Massara on centre wing. He's gone towards Lettick at half forward flank. No one's able to get the ball. Good running there by Massara. He's followed up to you. I reckon there's a few free kicks going given out there. But the play continues. Back to...
that's well done, Delaney. Mark.
Delaney kicked it to Howlett. Howlett, while he's falling to the ground, tried to get the handball away. It's come undone because it's ended up in the arms there of Feldman. Now they've got the loose man going. Over the top to Lurie. Lurie's going to run, is he? No, he gets the right foot to the ball. Stewart bearing down on him. And, Illy can't take the mark. Allen picks up the crumb. Now he goes wide. He's got Delaney out there. He's hotly pursued by... looks like Hurst. Oh, great tackle. Got to be holding the ball, surely. Oh. Not paid by the umpire. Well...
How could three of them get it so wrong?
That was just the perfect tackle, wasn't it? And he dropped the ball to boot. So out of bounds, centre wing. We've been playing 11 minutes first quarter. Werribee Central's 2 goals. Bell Post still 1.
Boundary throw in now, out of sight. Michaelson up against Stewart. Stewart gets it with the left fist towards Hawks. Can't take it with him. Off the back of the pack, Messina goes with the right foot towards half forward. Scott in front of Ryan Carr. Takes it on defensive 50 and will try and clear again. Goes short. It's all right, Bernardo's taking it. In front of Pollard. True half back on the outer side now. Goes to the right foot towards the middle. Miller and Howlett overrun it. Foot race. Nick Smith gets back there and coming through Bartolo. Backs himself. Right hand handball. Oh, Lurie had to sit and wait. In fact, it was McDonald. Goes through now to Feldman, who's had a very big influence so far. Troy Feldman goes with the right boot. Wobbly kick towards Hancock and brother Brett. Brother Brett's got it. Then plays for a free kick and didn't get one. And Justin Morley has gone with the left boot wide towards Foley and Smith. They can raffle it. Smith wins it. And takes the mark. Handball's on to Foley, who kept running. Great handball. Floated play. Over the top beautifully. The youngster doesn't sit up for him now. It does. He can handball over the top where he can kick a goal. And he has kicked a behind. Warren Foley. 1 goal, 1. His personal tally. They go to 2-1-13. Werribee Central's Bell Post to a 1 straight goal. 6 points. We've been playing 12 and a half minutes. And it's been fairly engrossing in the last 6 or 7 minutes. This game. And the kick-in will come from Gary Fairchild. Goes short towards Cameron Carr. That's okay. Takes the grab. Plays on now. Got Lurie wide. Going to run off for Stuka. Does well. Can Stuffer make it? No, he can't. But he keeps in front of him. Then he loses it. For Stuka comes at him. He goes left. He goes right. Then he gets wrapped up. He loses the footy. That should be dropping the ball. And it is. So Jason for Stuka with it.
Just... it's one criticism I make of Stuffer Lurie. Never uses the first option all the time. It's a bad fault he's got in his play.
So for Stuka's got it at half forward. Drives it long with the left boot back into the corridor. Connolly goes up early, or could have nearly taken the mark. Didn't get hands to it. Miller robs it away from Foley. Tries to get it out. Bartolo's there as well. Oh, he drags it back in. Nearly have to get rid of it. Does so. Slick hands towards Pollard. Sets him up. Michaelson runs through the middle. That's Brett. Goes wide towards Messina. Foot race. Can Messina keep it in? I think he might be able to. He's got a bit of time at halfback as well. He runs away. Howlett comes out down the field. Against Luddick, is it?
Luddick's kick, I think.
No. It's on the shoulder. Against... Luke Luddick on Brett Michaelson, so it'll come back. It looks like Messina's free kick at halfback on the outer side.
I reckon that went the wrong way. You can't tell when the ball's more than 5 metres away. The ball was 25 metres away then.
Well, the free kick is with Messina at halfback. Looking for an option. Hancock gave him one. So did Michaelson.
Good kick.
It is a good kick for distance. Michaelson goes up. Stewart. Oh, roved off the pack beautifully. And hands off quickly to Ryan Carr. Left foot kick around the corner. Shea Walker at centre half forward. Oh, great pick up. The big man turns around. Went right. Then went left. Then went the right boot. Elliott gave him a lead. Can he make it? No, he can't. Has to sit and wait for it. He does. Gets away from Hallam. Goes on the left boot towards Ryan Carr. That's pretty skillful. Ryan Carr's taking the mark in the left forward pocket. Is that play on? No. Kim Andrews now called time off. And it will be Ryan Carr in the left forward pocket on the boundary. He's got Shea Walker standing by himself. And he's got Feldman as well, Brett. And he gets him. That's
pretty loose checking.
I was going to say, that's loose checking, isn't it, from Werribee in the back line? Because he had a fair bit of time to run into that hole, Brett Feldman. He's marked it not more than 10 metres out.
And this is bread and butter for Brett.
Oh, that's it. Put the moz on him. Good work, coach. But he should kick it, Brett Feldman.
I just wonder how far he kicked the ball.
Oh, it's 10 metres, Pete. We're not totally back now, Pete.
It was 5 up and 5 down anyway.
Brett Feldman with the footy. Comes in, 10 metres out. Angle. kicks it. Bread and butter, as the coach said, and he's put it through for his first goal. And the second for Bell Post Hill. They're two straight goals, 12 points. Werribee Central's 2-1, 13. Victory Trophy's first quarter scoreboard, 15 minutes gone. They've settled nicely, Laurie.
Yeah, we're very happy with this at this point of time.
We get the runner out.
Yep, we're just cruising along nicely now. We've probably had a luck of a couple of free kicks, but you need that in finals footy.
Right, ball back in the centre of the ground with umpire Selcevic. Stewart there, going to do battle again with Michelson. Up it goes. Stewart, well, he's winning every tap down, but so far Werribee really not clearing the ball out of that centre area. Fastuca tried to get it to Howlett, but coming through was, good work on that occasion by Hawks. Can't take it. Hurst it is for Bell Post Hill. On the left foot, goes towards centre forward Feldman. Gets a handball to McDonald. McDonald for Bell Post Hill, drives to the lead there of Illick. He's got away from Helen by half a metre, and that's enough. He's taken the mark.
That's a good mark.
And he's
could have nearly got a walk too. I think this is where Werribee needs to tighten up. You know, I'm sure their coaching staff over there would be looking at the half back line. The Bell Post Hill blokes seem to be running through a marking contest, and they're running through the marking contest, and the ball's not being marked, and they're getting the second grab. Yep. So
Alex gone short, or puts Ryan Carr under pressure. Nick Smith's there, handball out. They might be able to break away here, Werribee. Now, Robbie Musara goes. It was down the field. He got dumped as he got the kick away. That was Mick Illick, and it will be down the field to Werribee. Roland Beck gets across there to take the free kick. It's at half back on the outer side. And Roland Beck just waiting for the footy to come back from Luke Luddick. And now Beck goes towards half forward. Howlett pushes Miller past the ball, but Miller got a hand to it and did well. Oh, then he trips over his own feet.
I just see Brett Feldman having some harsh words to say to Illick there. I'm not quite sure.
Kick the ball at the goals,
you're probably
I think. Yeah, yep. Not kick short. He's the full forward. You haven't kicked 70-odd goals by chipping the ball short, I would think. So I'm sure Brett, the experience there, just telling you to make sure next time he doesn't do that. Miller got the handball back from the rack. Hurst does well. Handball. Got a high tackle. Should get a free kick and will.
Quarter time, Ballerine. Anglesey 6-5. Ocean Grove yet to score.
Yep. Welshie is in strife. I think he backed Ocean Grove. Hancock keeps in front on centre wing on the outer side. Can he pick it up now? Stewart comes at him or falls over him. Now, Bell Post still first of the footy there. Can they get it out? Messina's there as well. And it will be a ball up. We've got some quarter-time AFL scores as well, Eric.
ASL, Collingwood 1-1, Brisbane 6-4.
Good, they're ruining the party.
Melbourne 7-2, Essendon 3-2. And Western Bulldogs 2-2, Port Adelaide 3 behind.
So they're the quarter-time AFL scores. Ball comes behind to Delaney. Picking it up easily is Feldman. Gets it on to McDonald. Handball to Lurie. This is where they look dangerous. Short little kick. Oh, over Pollard's head. Hancock comes at him. He gives it to the coach. And now Pollard wants to run away from Bennett. Kick around that corner towards Brett Feldman. Can't take it. Lurie's got it. Oh, went right, went left. Still for kick a goal. Oh, he'll tell you about that too, Stilfer. He loves a goal.
What did Laurie say before? Take the first option.
Stephen Lurie. Yeah, went left, went options. Right, and then kicked the goal. Great play, Stephen Lurie. Great running from the middle. And Bell Post Hill's third goal. They're three straight goals, 18. They lead Werribee Central's 2-1-13 Victory Trophy's first quarter scoreboard.
Actually, Peter, I've got an advantage. I have coached Bell Post Hill, and he had the same problem when I was coaching. It's just one of the... That's one of his problems.
He got you the sack, did he?
When he probably did. When he plays like that, he's a good player. You know, you've got to do, it's one of the signs in footy.
They almost overused it though, Laurie. The chip pass wasn't that good. They were just lucky enough to get away with it.
Lucky they had the numbers there.
I think Peter's point is pretty valid. The Werribee defence is pretty loose. In the middle, up it goes again. Stewart, well, Michelson got it this time ahead of Stewart, but unfortunately can't take advantage of it. Now it stacks on the mill, and the umpire will move in and, if he can disentangle the players there, we're still inside the centre square. Umpire Wilson it is.
It's interesting, one of the matchups is Lurie on Fastuca, and Lurie doesn't even seem to be all that interested in manning him up. He just says, well, I'm in front of him at the moment, I'm getting the ball, I'm going to make the play.
Oh, great smother by Cameron Carr on Luke Luddick, and Fastuca comes across. Carr, Lurie's there as well. He wants the boundary line, it might not make it. Chris Delaney gets across there. It's on half forward, Werribee attacking. Left half forward flank. He kicks it back in towards Lee, but chopping it off. He has been everywhere, Bevan Hurst. Won the club best in Ferris this year. Beat some big names, the Felbans, the Pollards, the McDonalds. And you can see why. I think he's having a great season, and he gets across there to take the mark in front of James Lee. Plays on now. Goes to the right boot, tries to drill it towards McDonald. He makes a contest. Oh, Sean Stewart gives away a free kick. No free kick coming to Lurie. McDonald, there's Delaney. He was going to go with a handball. Now he tries to get around Pollard. Tried to smother it. Got a kick away, though. Coming in. Taking a mark. No, is that high? Yes, it is. Against Ange Messina again, and on Roland Beck. And he's got it. Point of the centre square. Half forward flank. Couple of leads on. Lee. Now he wants to go wide to Luddick. Hasn't made it. Lee's there as well. Got his name written on it. Nobody near him. And James Lee has taken it.
Well, I don't know what happened to Fairchild on that occasion. Laurie seemed to get drawn into the play. It was 25 metres from Lee, and well, you don't get many easier marks as a full forward.
You'd be best qualified to answer this, Eric, but I think he might have preempted where that was going, Fairchild, I think, and he brought it around a little bit further.
Well, I think Werribee had players running in, and you know, they weren't being picked up, so poor old Gary got caught. But now we've got James Lee, 25 metres out. We're right behind it. Oh. He's been to the Goldie School of Kicking again this week because James Lee's kicked his first for the day. It's right through the middle. And the Victory Trophy Centre scoreboard, 21 minutes into the first quarter. Werribee Central's now regained the lead, 3-1-19. Bell Post Hill, three goals.
Is he allowed to go to your school even though you're coaching Bell Post Hill?
Not anymore.
He's going to your school, is he?
Yeah.
He's been to see Big Carl or somebody, has he?
Ooh, gee, that's dangerous. I tell you what, where I think one of the differences is, I think... The setup of the forward line with Walker at centre half forward and gives Illich a little bit more marking power in the forward line. The guys are running off the packs like you wouldn't believe, and having this Mickelson in the ruck is I think that's a blessing for the Bell Post Hill side.
Ball from Stewart goes towards centre half forward. Brett Mickelson can't pick it up. Running straight through the middle was Delaney. Can't take it with him. Held up at centre half forward, and we will have a ball up. We've been playing 22 minutes in the first term. It's 3-1 playing three straight. Werribee Central's by a point. Second semi-final here at St Albans Reserve. Howlett and Miller, the two number 25s, go at it. Lurie runs off for Stuga again. Handball to Messina, going to be under pressure from Musara. Gets it away to Herso. Gets a short left foot kick on centre wing. Foot race. Messina gets across there. Hancock as well. One Shepherds, one will go. Messina gives the Shepherd. Hancock gives it off quickly. Hurst kept running. Good play. Left foot kicks poor again. Puts Illich in the gun. Right next to him, Hallam. Oh, kept running Hurst again. Then he falls over at the crucial stage. Hancock kept running. Ryan Carr's in there as well. Loses the footy. And is out of bounds for a throw-in. Just on 50. On the outer side, half-forward flank for Bell Post Hill. Attacking the southern end.
Bell Post Hill appear to be running in numbers down there. A bit of a worry.
Yeah, they are. And I think it's because they've picked up the fact that the Werribee boys aren't prepared to man up across the back line. And, you know, while they keep doing that, you know, they've got in with a real big show.
Oh, Feldman, good mark in front of Andrew Howlett. And Feldman's told him all about it too, as has Howlett. And they're playing him pretty well because they're putting somebody in front of him, aren't they? They know they're going to go to him.
Yep. 3-on-1 there.
Yeah, 3-on-1. Miller falls over. Falls over his own feet. There's a bit of a dust patch there. He can still kick it to him. He's standing up now, and he has. Troy Feldman's laterally kicked it to Paul Miller, who goes now towards centre half forward. Carr behind Scott. Oh, he goes up high. Feldman can't take it with him. He's held up by Justin Morley. And it will be right on 50. It'll be a ball up. So Brett Feldman couldn't get away from Justin Morley's tackle there. Mark Hancock down to do the ruck work against Stewart. Hancock goes up, tries to nullify him. The umpire gives a good shepherd. Oh, coming through. That's high. Ryan Carr came through at pace. Gave it away. Roland Beck will take it. Just inside defensive 50 for the Centurions. He's got Hawks wide. He goes in that direction now. For Stuka's there and Lurie. Hawks should be able to take the mark. He can. Handball's back to Nick Smith running at half back. Now, he wants to switch play, does he? Yes, he does. Bernardo gives him a lead on the opposite side, half forward flank. In fact, it's Hallam. And he's run a long way down. Illich's had to follow him down. He's at half forward. He drills it in towards the uncle. Heath Buck takes it. Great running, Matty Hallam.
I think that's the difference. That's what Bell Post Hill have been doing all the quarter. And it's just taken a bit of initiative from one of the Werribee guys to say, let's run into a hole and make a bit of play.
Albeit at the full back. The problem was Illich wasn't prepared to chase him, Laurie.
Yeah, look, Eric, when they do go into that forward spot, though, they go in there well. They seem to hit a target most times when they get in there.
Heath Buck has sprayed it. One behind to Heath Buck.
Yeah, just getting back to what you said before, Peter, I think the Bell Post Hill is they're worrying Werribee, their short handballs from the packs, and, you know, it makes it difficult when you're a defender. When a handball comes out, and you're probably expecting a kick.
Oh, Foley.
Cool. Ball came in from Feldman. Look for Bartolo. Foley nearly chopped it off now. It's a race. Connolly, can he pick it up? He gets a good shepherd and can run away with the left boot. Goes towards centre-half forward. Feldman tries to use his body. Ryan Carr's there as well. Scott as well. Does well. K Can't get the handball away clearly. Over the head of Morley, foot race, Hurst now, should lead in the race, and gets it. Got Feldman, oh, it's a poor kick off the boot though, into the right forward pocket. Which way is it going to bounce? It's going to bounce out, and I don't think Bernardo can keep it in his cart. It is out of bounds for a boundary thrown in the right forward pocket. About 35 minutes around from Bell Post Hills goal. They're three straight. They trail 3-2-20 Werribee Centrals. 25 minutes gone. Stewart and Shea Walker through the ruck work. Boundary umpire throws it in. Stewart in front. Taps it down. Hurst runs at pace. Leaves the footy behind. Bennett's in there fighting hard. As his Hancock, the umpire will come in and bounce it up.
They're going to need a surgeon here at the end of the game, I reckon.
Why that?
Separate Lurie from Fistuka.
Ball thrown up. Half forward flank for the Bell Post Hill side. Stewart gets the tap toward the half forward area. Pollard can't pick it up. It's Beck on top of him. And the umpire will do it all again. It's a throw up just inside the 50-metre arc. In the forward line for the Bell Post Hill side. Stewart in front. Gets a tap toward the Werribee goal. Running onto the ball is Pollard. Gets it up. Turns on the left foot. Good looking kick. He's found Feldman at the centre of the ground. And that's Feldman Troy. But, well, he's muffed it. That's been well smothered off the boot. But it's only gone as wide there as Massara for Bell Post Hill. It's gone. Well, heading back for Pollard. They're going across the ground at the moment. Now they've come undone, Bell Post Hill, because it's fallen to Foley's arms. He's eluded his opponent. He's had a bounce. Now he's heading forward. It's very good. He's drawn the player. So Smith's out in his own now for Werribee Centrals. What can he do with it? There's another player who's run well there. Delaney's run to centre-half forward. And on this occasion, it's good running by the Werribee Central side. They've run to the spaces. They've used the ball well. And culminating in Chris Delaney taking the mark 25 metres out, directly in front, right in the corridor. Have the breeze behind him and the opportunity to put another one on the board for the Werribee Central side. But
I tell you what, Eric, for a 17-year-old young fella, Foley's pressure there, and he was very, very cool. He took his time. He took a bounce. He weighed up a couple of options.
Well, Chris Delaney's capped it off for the Werribee side. Beautiful kick right over the goal umpire's head. And that's goal number 4 for the Werribee Central side. Victory Trophy scoreboard now. 27 minutes gone first quarter. Werribee Central's 4-2-26. They lead Bell Post Hill 3 goals straight. 18.
It was just that mucking around at half forward, wasn't it, Laurie, that turned that over?
Yeah, exactly. Troy Feldman, wrong option. Should have kicked the ball rather than look for the handball, of course.
But handball straight to hooks.
It's been successful, I suppose you stick with it. But we have to get someone into that gap. Where we go to that spot, that exact spot where that guy kicked Delaney, they go there every time. Bell Post will have to drop someone in there.
Stewart taps it over the back to Smith. Great ruck and roving work. Goes towards centre forward. Bounces over to Foley. Turns around off one step and goes bang and kicks the goal. Oh, it's as easy as that. Warren Foley's second goal.
Well, that's actually the first time Stewart's actually got it to one of his own players. Every ball up, he's put it behind him, palmed it behind him, and that's the first time there was a clear possession from Stewart.
Stewart came off a short run there. Michelson came from a long way back. Pollard's just gone into him and said to him, don't come off such a long run. They're only throwing it up pretty short there, aren't they?
Yeah, and exactly, Peter, when we spoke to him the other week there, this is one of the things where he's improved his game. Last year he wasn't as adaptable as that. I mean, that was great play, that to Wong that back. He's had 5 hit-outs from the centre bounce, Stewart, at this point in time.
Well, umpire Zeljevic throws the ball up against Stewart. Michelson goes up. They both get there for Stuka. Gets it, can't run through the pack. Hawks is there as well. Handball out wide to Beck, running off the half-back flank. Gets away from Hurst. Goes wide, Bartolo and Foley. Foot race now, Foley. Works to his front, then Bartolo does well to get it back. Held on to. Might have got a free kick, none forthcoming. Get a handball to Hurst. Hurst right on the boundary line at half back. Goes with the right foot kick towards Brett Feldman. Stewart comes across, takes the mark. Brett Feldman looking for a free, doesn't get one. Stewart with a left foot goes towards half forward. Pack develops over the back. Foley couldn't take it with him. Bartolo, oh, threw it out to McDonald. Handball towards Hurst. Has to get it back. Now goes with the, oh, great smother by I think that's Adrian Bernardo down there, is it? No, it might be Carrington. It is. Jason Carrington. Great smother. Hurst tried to get the kick away, and we will have a boundary throw-in between wing and half forward. Werribee attacking the northern end. Stewart gets it down, roved there by Hurst. Left foot kick, foot race now, Feldman. And he'll get a shepherd from Pollard, does he? Delaney. You're right, he says, and he goes with the right. Great kick, Ryan Carr. You can't beat that. Hit Ryan Carr right on the chest. Now Walker's down there. Oh, Ryan Carr turns it over, I think. Scott's there. Running Scott. Through Musara, handball towards Morley and Scott again. Ryan Carr has to butter up. Scott's over there. He might be able to win it back here. Morley's there. Oh, Walker runs through. No free kick play on the call. Bernardo's got it. Goes with a left foot kick towards Ludic at half forward. Oh, great play. Holds it up and then takes it away. Goes on the left boot. Drills it towards full forward. Oh, the uncle.
Ooh.
And he has...
And he's got 50.
Yeah.
He's got something.
He might
Simon
have a
Connolly.
Card even.
And
he's looking in his pocket for something. I don't think it's money.
No, he's Buck.
I think he's produced a card.
He's looking for money.
Simon Connolly it is.
He'll be off.
Who will be off, we believe.
So might he's Buck.
Yeah. He took a pretty strong mark.
Heath Buck's a pretty tough boy, though.
Yeah.
And he's inside 50. You watch.
The only thing is the legs are a bit rubbery at the minute.
They are a bit rubbery, but I'll guarantee you he'll have his kick.
You better put the stopwatch on, Eric.
They're down to 17 men, too. Simon Connolly's been sent off. Well, he has been reported.
At the 30-minute mark of the first quarter. So that's going to be the major portion of the second quarter, Laurie.
Yes. It's a blow, isn't it?
Yes.
Oh, Welshie, if you're listening, the uncle's got the footy. And we get 50 as well.
It's got to be 50 as well, isn't
it? He's got 50.
Yeah. It's a gimme.
He's coming down. 50 metre penalty. So Heath Buck.
Is he only just blown time off?
Yeah.
Has he? Okay, well, that's good. But anyway,
he's busy.
Heath Buck's got it. And he will kick from the goal square. He hasn't kicked a goal yet. He will now. And he's recovered all right, Pete, as you said. Heath Buck walks in, kicks the first.
There's two
types. Afternoon for him.
Jace, there's two types of white line fever. There's the one where you run over and you get really cranky when you run on the ground, and the other's when you see the 50 metre line and you're inside it.
And
you got the ball and you're in the forward line.
Well, Werribee Central's are steady. They're 6-2-38. They lead Bell Post till 3 straight goals, 18. Victor Trophy's first quarter scoreboard, 31 and a half minutes gone. And just need to hold it, don't they, Laurie?
Yes. Look, if we could run the tape back for this first quarter, I'd like to know how many times the ball's been kicked in that exact position. There's definitely a plan there.
It happened last week as well. So if they'd have watched it, Bell Post Hill, surely they'd have realised.
Yeah, but you're saying drop someone in there, Laurie. I don't know that it's that easy, because as soon as you drop someone in there, it means someone else is not manned up.
Yeah, you know, you're probably right. It's not as easy as it's said, I guess. Yeah.
They should, if they man up tighter, that hold would disappear.
Back in the centre, 32 minutes gone. Off the ground on this occasion, Bell Post still go forward. Scott is in the way, but can't control the ball.
Ooh.
Well, one-on-one contest there was Hallam and Carr. Carr's not too brilliant either, but the ball's fallen to Hancock at centre-half forward. He's turned round, gone bang on the right foot, and has kicked the goal. So very quick answer for the Bell Post Hill side. And 32 minutes gone in the quarter.
Packed a scrum down at centre-half forward to the Bell Post Hill.
All around Ryan Carr, aren't they?
The Victory Trophy scoreboard now, 6-2-38, Werribee Central's 4 goals straight, 24, Bell Post Hill. But there was two players running straight at the ball then.
There was nothing in that, Eric.
Tough.
You've got to go straight at the cherry.
That's right.
That's exactly what he did.
Well, very good response there, Laurie, from your side.
Yes, we needed that. Well, you said it was a 3-goal win, so I'm still...
So you're in front.
We're still cruising.
6-2-38, Werribee Central's Bell Post still 4 straight, 24. Back in the centre, Stewart and Michelson again. Stewart gets it down this time. Musara comes off the wing, can't take with him. Look at Stewart. He tried to take it away like a ruck rover. Handball to McDonald, who chopped it off. Up in the air. Fistuka goes up. No 10, will be play on. There is a siren for quarter time. And at quarter time, it is Bell Post Hill. 4 straight goals, 24. They trail Werribee Central 6-2-38. The goal kickers at quarter time for Werribee Central's 2 to Warren Foley. Singles to Luke Gladick, Heath Buck, James Lee and Chris Delaney. For Bell Post Hill, singles to Ryan Carr, Mark Hancock, Brett Feldman and Stephen Lurie. And Peter might go out and have a bit of a listen to... Well, you might go and listen to...